heart beats fast, colors and promises. How to be brave? How can I love when I'm afraid to fall? But watching you stand alone, all of my doubt suddenly goes away somehow.
Together, this man and this woman, holy matrimony. The bond and covenant of a marriage was established by God in creation, and our Lord Jesus Christ adorned this manner of life by his presence and first miracle at a wedding in Cana of Galilee. It signifies to us a mystery a mystery that also speaks of Christ and His church, and the Scripture commends it to be honored among all. The union of husband and wife is intended by God for their mutual joy, for the help and comfort given each other in prosperity and in adversity, and when it is God's will, for the procreation of children and their nurture in the knowledge and love of the Lord. Therefore, marriage is not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, deliberately, and in accordance with the purposes for which it was instituted by God. Into this union, Adam and Monet now come to be joined. To Monet, will you have this man to be your husband, to live together with him in the covenant of marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, as long as you both shall live? Adam, will you have this woman to be your wife, to live together with her in the covenant of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful unto her as long as you both shall live? Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
And
promise of companionship, of having someone to share all of life's experiences. Marriage does not promise that there will not be any rough times, just the assurance that there will always be someone who cares and will help you through to better times. Marriage does not promise eternal romance, just eternal love and commitment. Marriage cannot prevent disappointments, disillusionment, or grief, but it can offer hope, acceptance, and comfort. Marriage can't protect you from making individual choices or shelter you from the world, but it will help to reassure you that there is someone by your side who truly cares when your will hurts and makes you feel vulnerable. Marriage offers the promise that there will be someone waiting to listen, to console, and to inspire. Marriage is the joining of two people who share the promise that only marriage can make, to share the sunshine and the shadows, and to experience a richer, more fulfilling life because of it.
Someone called me this week and asked, from all my years of experience as a pastor, what advice I would give to a young pastor. I thought, well, I guess there's something that comes from getting old. But I thought it was important. What advice could I give as a pastor to somebody coming in? But I thought also, nobody's ever asked me my advice about marriage. Nobody's ever asked me my advice about marriage. So I thought I'd share mine with you since somebody asked. And here's my one word: communicate. Be clear on expectations. So with that in mind, I have about a dozen statements to help us be clear at the beginning of your marriage. And today I'm speaking for Adam and every married man here. Come to us with a problem only if you want help solving it. That's what we do. Sympathy is what your girlfriends are for. I think we'll all understand this, man. Yes and no are perfectly acceptable answers to almost every question. Number three here. Ask for what you want. Let us be clear on this one. Subtle hints do not work. Strong hints do not work. Obvious hints do not work. Just say it. In the interest of honesty, forever. every man here, sometimes we are not thinking about you. But that's not true today. Crying is blackmail. We don't remember dates, so mark birthdays and anniversaries on the calendar. Remind us frequently beforehand. Anything we said 6 months ago is inadmissible in an argument. In fact, all comments become null and void after 7 days. This is very important. If something we said can be interpreted in two ways, and one of the ways makes you sad or angry, we meant the other one. Whenever possible, please say whatever you have to say to us during commercials. All men see only in 16 colors, like a Windows default. Peach, for example, is a fruit, not a color. Pumpkin is also a fruit. We have no idea what mauve is. If we ask what is wrong and you say nothing, we will act like nothing's wrong. We know you're lying, but it's just not worth the hassle. And another one, just for the record, and as we get older, this is very important for our wives to understand, I'm in shape. Round is a shape. I hope that helps. Actually, these words from the Apostle Paul are harder to practice, but much more helpful. This is from a translation I've been using regularly. It's from 1 Corinthians 13. Very important today, and it certainly emphasizes the reading we just heard. If I speak with human eloquence and angelic ecstasy, but don't love, I'm nothing but the creaking of a rusty gate. If I speak God's word with power, revealing all his mysteries and making everything plain as day, if I have faith that says to a mountain, jump, and it jumps, but I don't have love, I'm nothing. If I give everything I own to the poor, even go to the stake to be burned as a martyr, but I don't love, I've gotten nowhere. So no matter what I say, what I believe, what I do, I'm bankrupt without love. Love never gives up. Love cares more for others than for self. Love doesn't want what it doesn't have. Love doesn't strut. Doesn't have a swelled head. Doesn't force itself on others. Isn't always me first. Love doesn't fly off the handle. Doesn't keep score of the sins of others. Doesn't revel when others grovel. Takes pleasures in the flowering of truth. Puts up with anything. Trust God always. Always looks for the best. Never looks back, but keeps going to the end. These words you now speak to each other express your commitment to carry through to that end. Monet and Adam have written their own vows to express their love and commitment to each other. Yeah, you may be seated.
Share with you. I promise to be your forever one and only, and to show you faithfulness and deepest love. I promise to be honest, forgiving, and loyal for the rest of our lives together. I promise that when you are down and your faith dwindles, I will pray for you. When you are happy, I will exude joy, even when you buy another Mopar. I will cherish every moment I have with you, during the good times and bad. In sickness and in health, I will always be by your side. I vow to respect you as a man of God, the head of the household, a husband, and as a father. I swear to stand by you and your son as time flies by and as we grow old. Beauty fades, but love only grows. When you need a shoulder to cry on, an ear to listen, and a hand to hold, I will be there. We are no longer Adam and Renee. We are now Mr. and Mrs. Today I give you my heart. Today I give you my hand. And today I give you the promise of my own life.
I'm going to call Adam's two sons up here.
Ryan Cade and Zachary David. When I met your father, I had no idea I would not only fall in love with him, but also the two of you. My life has been forever changed since you two walked into my life. From the first time you, Ryan, called me mayonnaise because you couldn't say my name, and from the first time you, Zach, fell asleep in my arms, you guys had me hooked. Your daddy and I have become best friends over the past 5 years. I pray that as daddy and I begin our new life together as husband and wife, that I only do my part, which is keeping you happy, being fair, disciplining you when you do wrong, and teaching you how to do different tasks, life tasks, as you grow. I will not replace anyone in your life, as you both have your daddy and you both have your mommy. I will be your friend, make you spaghetti when you're hungry, and homemade sweet tea when you're thirsty. I will always be here when you need someone to talk to, or when you want to go outside and play ball. I love you both with all my heart. And as I take on your daddy's last name today, and share it with you, I promise to always take care of you, Ryan, and you, Zach. I love you guys.
Adam and Renee are exchanging rings as a sign of their commitment to each other. Have the rings brought up here. Let's pause for prayer. Bless, O Lord, these rings as a symbol of the vows by which this man and this woman have bound themselves to each other through Jesus Christ, our Lord. I will say a phrase at a time and you can repeat this. I give you this ring as a symbol of my love, and with all that I am and all that I have, I honor you in the name of the Father and of the Son and the Holy Spirit.
I give this ring
as a symbol of my love, and with all that I am and all that I have, I honor you in the name of the Father and of the Son and the Holy Spirit. Now that Adam and they have given themselves to each other by solemn vows, with the joining of hands, giving and receiving of rings, by authority committed to me as a minister, and by the laws of the state of Pennsylvania, I pronounce that they are husband and wife, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Those whom God has joined together, let no one put apart. Begin their lives together, and in scripture I find that the blessing comes when the raising of the right hand, so if you see the raising of the hand, that's what it means. The right hand is always a hand of blessing in scripture. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you. The Lord mercifully with his favor look upon you and fill you with all spiritual benediction and grace, that you may faithfully live together in this life, and in the age to come have life everlasting. Amen. I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Adam Bottenfield.
She's up on the top of the hill there.
Thank you. I'm going to start beating you with the stick.
Me?
How do my knees look?
Erase that.
We're just gonna go fix circle and come right back.
Ladies and gentlemen, if I could have your attention for a moment, we are going to be bringing in the bridal party in about 15 minutes, and then we'll...
The bathroom?
Yeah.
It's in that gray building there.
Okay. Photo booth.
I think that's where it's at.
In the gray building?
I think so. I thought that's what someone said earlier.
You're the best, Tommy Taylor. Tell me.
Yeah, it does.
Thank you.
again so they can actually hear you. All right, the parents of the groom, Barry and Janet Bottenfield. The grandmother of the groom, Doris Hoover. Tonight? Are you guys ready to have fun tonight? Okay, that's okay. All right, let's bring in the bridal party. First up, we have our flower girl, Raylan Miller, escorted by the ring bearer, Zachary Bottenfield. Bottenfield, escorted by junior groomsman Ryan Bottenfield. Let's give him a big hand, guys. All right, next up we have Jennifer Stifler, escorted by Dave Donaldson. Angel Butler, escorted by Ben Whitesoul. Alicia Smith, escorted by Justin Smith. By Jordan Ritchie. Whitney Smith, escorted by Adam Henry. Not least, Caitlin Deputy 4, escorted by Jake Hall. All right, I was going to ask you all to stand up, but we're a little tight quarters here, so I just need you to clap along where you're sitting, okay? You guys are doing good. Keep going. Good? Oh, come on, keep going. All right, ladies and gentlemen, it is my great honor, privilege, and pleasure to introduce to you, for the second time in the history of the universe, Mr. and Mrs. Adam Bottenfield! Seated. That was an excellent effort. I expect better throughout the evening. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to hand the microphone over to Reverend Lou Button, who's going to ask a blessing for our dinner.
Let's pause for prayer. Father, this is a special occasion. We're here among family and friends to recognize and to celebrate the wedding of Monet and Adam. May we also recognize your presence at the table. We are married in the eyes of God and the sight of God, and we live and we share in His eyes, and may this be a special day for us. Bless each one who is here, in the name of Jesus. Amen.
All right, guys, I will be releasing your tables, so I do accept brides. Brides. I accept brides if you're hungry. Reverend, all right, I'd like to see that.
Maid of Honors. Everybody has a friend they've been friends with for a really long time. Well, that's Monet and I. We've known each other through some very awkward stages. At one point, Monet thought she wanted red hair, but in the process, it went gray. I sported a nice boy cut myself in junior high. We've been through a lot, the ups and downs and the highs and the lows. And as the years went by, we saw some heartbreak. We saw some great times. And then Adam came along, and I gained another friend. And they will dispute you as long as the night goes, but I was there when they met, okay? I was there. I don't care what anybody says. And I remember it, and I remember Monet going on and on about Adam. And in Monet fashion, she told all the details. He's doing some remodeling of his house. He's got some recessed lighting, and we watched Sweet Home Alabama. So she went all kinds of details, and she was all kinds of excited. And I thought, you know what? Let's ride this one out. And here we are 5 years later, and it was sort of a package deal for poor Adam. He got like two of us because I started coming around a lot, honestly. But needless to say, we're here today, 5 years later, and I couldn't be happier for them. We should thank them that we're here because they fell in love. So if you would, give them another round of applause. And this whole wedding prep thing has been pretty crazy for everyone involved. We've helped out the very best that we could. It's come together beautifully. And at times it seemed like our event was getting bigger than our purpose. And our purpose is to celebrate two people that fell in love and they're starting their life together. And you know, I'm sure each and every one of us questioned at some point, why are we doing this? Why are we here? Why are we hanging this thing on this corner and blah, blah, blah. But you know what? Last night, she gave us at rehearsal dinner, each of the girls, the guys got their knives, and each of the girls, we got a bracelet. And on our bracelets, there was initials, and there were initials for each of us who have kids, our kids' initials, and it was so sweet. And it just sort of, it reminded me why we were here, because of the big hearts that Monet has, the big heart that Monet has, and the big heart that Adam has. We love them. So I think that sort of relates to their marriage as they start out. Never lose sight of the purpose, and you guys will be just fine. I have every faith in you guys. You guys are going to do great. Just don't forget each other at the end of the day. So I love you both very much, and let's toast.
Well, I've grown up with Adam. He was always older than I was. I learned everything you can imagine from Mr. Adam Bottenfield here. You know, from you can imagine anything. Beginning to end, and we used to, you know, we played in the dirt piles and in the woods, and I was always the little guy. But, you know, they weren't mean to me or nothing. But anyways, but in our later years, me and Adam became really good friends, and we hang out, we hunt and stuff. But just a fun little story, when we were kids, I played baseball like it was my job. I loved it so much, and Adam did it too, and he'd come down and play ball with me, and I was so excited to finally have somebody to play ball with, and he'd come down over the hill, you know, I'm all pumped up, and he'd come down, he'd bring the ball, and he'd say, you know, you pitch to me first, you can be Gary Pettis, and I'll be Frank Thomas. If anybody knows who Gary Pettis was, he wasn't any good. And he had a funny name. So I pitched to him about 3 pitches into it. He'd hit one over the barn and then say, oh, I gotta go. And I'd spend the rest of the day in the cow poop looking for my baseball. So that's how we grew up. Like I said, later on, we've become really close friends, and it all worked out good. Anyways, Monet and Adam, I just wish the best for you. And he told me yesterday, he told me this, and I thought this was pretty cool. He said that I can't think of one thing about her that I don't like. And I thought that was pretty cool. So congratulations, and I hope for a lot of happy years.
What's going to happen over there? Is it going to be nice and gentle? And, oh. Who instigated that? I want to know. Who started that? Adam, if there's one thing I can give you.
beside me.